Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday, Memorial of St. Ignatius of Loyola. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who raised up St. Ignatius of Loyola in your church to further the greater glory of your name, grant that by his help we may imitate him in fighting the good fight on earth and merit to receive with him a crown in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses turned and came down the mountain with the two tablets of the commandments in his hands, tablets that were written on both sides, front and back, tablets that were made by God, having inscriptions on them that were engraved by God himself. Now, when Joshua heard the noise of the people shouting, he said to Moses, "That sounds like a battle in the camp." But Moses answered, "It does not sound the cries of victory, nor does it sound the cries of defeat. The sounds that I hear are cries of revelry." As he drew near the camp, he saw the calf and the dancing. With that, Moses' wrath flared up, so that he threw the tablets down and broke them on the base of the mountain. Taking the calf they had made, he fused it in the fire and then ground it down to powder, which he scattered on the water and made the children of Israel drink. Moses asked Aaron, "What did these people ever do to you that you should lead them into so grave a sin?" Aaron replied, "Let not my Lord be angry. You know well enough how prone the people are to evil. They said to me, 'Make us a God to be our leader.' As for the man Moses who brought us out of the land of Egypt, we do not know what has happened to him." So I told them, "Let anyone who has gold jewelry take it off." They gave it to me and I threw it into the fire and this calf came out. On the day Moses said to the people, On the next day Moses said to the people, "You have committed a grave sin. I will go up to the Lord, then perhaps I may be able to make atonement for your sin." So Moses went back to the Lord and said, "Ah, this people has indeed committed a grave sin in making a god of gold for themselves. If you would only forgive their sin, if you will not, then strike me out of the book that you have written." The Lord answered, "Him only who has sinned against me will I strike out of my book. Now go and lead the people to the place I have told you. My angel will go before you. When it is time for me to punish, I will punish them for their sin." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Our fathers made a calf in Horeb and adored a molten image. They exchanged their glory for the image of a grass-eating bullock.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
They forgot the God who had saved them, who had done great deeds in Egypt, wondrous deeds in the land of Ham, terrible things at the Red Sea.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Then he spoke of exterminating them, but Moses, his chosen one, withstood him in the breach to turn back the destructive wrath.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Father willed to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of His creatures. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus proposed a parable to the crowds. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all the seeds. Yet when full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches. He spoke to them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened. All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables, to fulfill what had been said through the prophet. I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what has lain hidden from the foundation of the world. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today, let me invite you to reflect on 2 points. So from the Gospel, and then a third point will be a sort of synthesis. No, about first the mustard seed, no, and then the second is the yeast, no, in the parable of the kingdom. And then I'd like to reflect on this on the perspective of the feast day of Ignatius of Loyola. No. First, about the mustard seed. No, when you take a look at it, Ignatius, in a sense, gave us some mustard seed, so to speak. No, and one of the most prominent would be the Society of Jesus. Now, remember, the Society of Jesus started, no, with 7 companions. No, there was no real grand plan, no, to make it the one of the biggest actually religious congregations in the history of the church. No, and one of the congregations, one of the orders that really had a tremendous impact on the church and on human civilization in general. So again, that mustard seed, no, beginning with the first 7 companions that Ignatius recruited, no, and they pronounced their vows in Paris, no. Of course, the original was to imitate the apostles, no. Ignatius always wanted to go to the Holy Land and live the life of Christ and the life of the apostles. But eventually that led them to Rome, no. When they could not get a ship to go to the Holy Land, he gave a deadline. If we don't go by this time, when we go to Rome and ask the Holy Father, no, the Pope, to dispose of us, whatever he wants us to do. And that is the beginning of the society, no, as we know it now. No, but again, you see that mustard seed, no, that Ignatius planted, no, that desire to serve God, to serve His church, everything for the greater glory of God, and beginning with 7 companions, no. And then the second point is the yeast, no. When you take a look at the yeast, no, you also reflect on the influence that Ignatius had, no, in the church, in spirituality, and in different aspects of human civilization. No? We mentioned yesterday, no, that he gave us, of course, the Society of Jesus. He gave us the spiritual exercises, which I think is the center of all the yeast, no? And from there you have retreats, you have, as we mentioned yesterday, spiritual discernment, no? But all of these now, no, created a tremendous impact on the church, no? With regard to Jesuit education, with regard to, as I said, retreats and discernment, no? And his influence, the influence of the Jesuits in various fields, no? Not just in education, but in science, in the arts, in mission work, and even in what they call this political science, they delved on so many aspects, no, and all of these came from the spiritual exercises, no. That was the yeast that Ignatius gave the world, no, and looking at all this now, no, we draw encouragement and inspiration from this, no, that sometimes the little things that we do, the seeds, the mustard seeds that we plant, no, will bear fruit, no, much more than we can imagine, no. The little acts of kindness and the good that we do will bear fruit. That good things begin with small but very sincere and very deeply committed acts, no. And then of course the yeast, no, that again, the little that we do can have a tremendous influence on others, no. So it is very important that we consciously and generously, no, perform acts of kindness, no, hoping that it will influence other people. Of course, praying, we don't do it for the sake of gaining the attention, no? But with the prayer that it will help make life better for other people. And then the third and final point is about Ignatius, no? I think very few people know that really the heart of Ignatian spirituality is to find God in all things, no? Well, no, it's true that for the greater glory of God, the excellence and the hard work and that in a sense that doing all the work for the church, all of these are very much rooted, no, in Ignatian spirituality. But the core and the heart of it is finding God in all things, no? And we see that in that prayer, no, take and receive, no, wherein Ignatius says that everything that I have, everything that I am, no, everything is from you, no, everything is God. That's why he offers back everything to God and he says, give me only your love and your grace, and this is what matters, no. But again, no, Ignatius, no, in his life, no, here is a man who very actively created some of the greatest institutions in the world, in the church, no, and in the world also, no, in general. And yet here was a man who, towards the end of his life, what mattered to him is to find God in all things, no. And this image that we had placed here in our altar and had with us as companion, so to speak, during this month of Ignatius, when we started our novena, no, for the feast day, this I think symbolizes, no, that finding God in all things. This is Ignatius contemplating the stars, no. And let me read to you an excerpt from the book Alone and on Foot, no, a very beautiful biography of Ignatius. I'd like to read that account, no, that Father Pedro de Ribendanera, one of the closest Jesuits to Ignatius, no, he was a novice and Ignatius was his novice master because nobody wanted to take him in, no. Pillo siya, no. And this is what Father Pedro de Ribendanera wrote about Ignatius, describing Ignatius contemplating the stars. And I quote, he would go to the terrace or a place where all the heavens were visible, no. There he would stand, take off his cap, and remain still for a short while in his eyes lifted towards the sky. Then he would kneel and bow down before God. Afterwards, he would sit down with tears streaming so gently and silently. And here was Ignatius, no? Siguro makita natin na si San Ignacio ay ang dami niyang binigay sa simbahan, di ba? Sabi nga natin yung mustard seed, di ba? Yung pagtatanim niya ay nagsimula sa 7 kasamahan, 7 companions. At mula dito, na ito yung naging Society of Jesus o mga Jesuita na hanggang ngayon ang isa naging pinakamalaking kongregasyon, ano, sa buong mundo, sa kasaysayan ng simbahan. At nagsimula yan sa 7 magkakasama na meron silang pangarap na nagmula do sa spiritual exercises, ano, na paglingkuran ng Diyos at ang simbahan. At makikita natin, di ba, yung ding yeast, ano, yung libadura, ano, yun din yung, ano, yung mga tinanim ni San Ignacio, yung spiritual exercises, no, ang kanyang yung mga retreats na nagbunga mula sa spiritual exercises, yung pangingilatis or discernment, Jesuit education, lahat ito ay naging malaking impluwensya, no, sa simbahan at sa mundo, no. At ito ay lahat nagsimula, ano, doon sa mga bagay, maliliit na bagay na pinagsimulan. At nakakatuwa kasi itong si San Ignacio na ang dami-dami niyang nagawa, ang dami-dami niyang naitatag para sa sangkatauhan at sa simbahan, yun sa katapusan ng buhay niya, ang pinakamahalaga sa kanya ay yung masasabi natin, yung buod at puso ng kanyang spirituality. Yung makita niya ang Diyos sa lahat ng bagay. Finding God in all things. Sabi nga, di ba, ni Pedro Ribendanera, nung tumanda na siya, nung nandun siya sa Jesuit headquarters, ano, sa Roma katabi ng Vatikano, sabi ni Ribendanera, papanik siya, no, sa terrace o kung saan man na makikita niya ang, ano, no, ang buong langit, ano. At doon sabi ni Ribendanera, tatanggalin niya ang kanyang sombrero at sandali titingnan lang niya, no, yung kalangitan, no. Tapos noon luluhod siya at siya ay, ano, yuyuko sa harap ng Diyos. At sabi nga ni Ribendanera, mauupo siya at yung luha niya gumigilid sa kanya. Kasi nakita niya ang Diyos sa lahat ng bagay, sa sanlilikha. Today, let us pray for that, no? That like Ignatius, we may be given that grace to find God in all things. And in finding God in all things, may we become mustard seeds in a world in need of so much service and love. May we become the yeast in the world in need also of so much inspiration. We are God's children, but in humble prayer we come to Him as servants of the kingdom, seeking to do our duty and asking Him to increase our faith. In prayer, let us ask Him, Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians and those who profess belief in Christ may grow in faith and love for one another as a sign of God's kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our personal faith may increase and that we may acknowledge our complete dependence on God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those whose faith has grown cold and who are overcome by despair and anxiety may be blessed with new enthusiasm to renew their Christian commitment, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray for all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we continue to pray for all those who are affected by the recent typhoon. And let us pray for the Society of Jesus and their works for the Church. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May these offerings we make to you as we celebrate St. Ignatius be pleasing, Lord God, and grant that the sacred mysteries which have made the fount of all holiness may sanctify us too in the truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Ignatius, you bid your Church rejoice. So do you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Ignatius of Loyola and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly serve and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build the world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offered their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes all, so Filipinos may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Rock,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. May the sacrifice of praise that we have offered with thanksgiving in honor of Saint Ignatius, O Lord, bring us to exalt you, your majesty, without end through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And again, let's continue to pray for all the victims of the recent typhoon. And then also, we'd like to thank you. I forgot, I was not able to announce this yesterday. But our Ale Kapwa Fund as of last week is 29,464,454.58. So maraming salamat po for your continued support. Of course, please support the Ale Kapwa Expanded Campaign. Then also for the victims of the recent typhoon. But maraming salamat po for your continued generosity and support. Have a good day ahead, have a good week ahead, and happy feast day to all the Jesuits and to all those who follow Ignatian spirituality. Maraming pong salamat.
I can't feed 5,000. But I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.